I am the stone that the builder refused. I am the visual, the inspiration that made ladies sing the blues. I'm the spark that makes your idea bright. The same spark that lights the dark so that you can know your left from your right. I am the ballad in your box, the bullet in the gun, the inner glow that lets you know to call your brother son. The story that just begun, the promise of what's to come. And I'ma remain a soldier till the war is won. Chop, chop, chop. Chop, chop, chop.
Here's something black people have known for a couple of hundred years. Niggas are crazy. Now, black people don't like to talk about crazy niggas in public because white people may be listening, but I'm afraid the secret might be out.
Former singer Whitney Houston appeared in court alongside husband Bobby Brown, who's facing battery charges for allegedly beating his once respectable wife.
Hell to the not, Bobby, don't hit me. See, we have this TV show, and it's our TV show, and I was trying to get a little bit more time on it.
It's my show, bitch!
You know, I think they're on drugs.
Let's see what's on BET. Oh, lordy lord.
Oh, shake it to the right. Shake it.
You boys, cover your eyes. Shake. That's at least something to the imagination. That's just showing too much booty.
And on our talking points this evening, it seems like the hip-hop community is trading in their gold chains for gold showers. Hip-hop singer R. Kelly is on trial again this week for sharing some of his liquid bling with yet another underage girl. Some advice for Mr. Kelly. Next time, use a golden shower curtain and keep your golden showers to yourself.
What's wrong with a man giving away a golden shower? Sounds like a nice gift to me. What? Shoot, I wish somebody gave me a golden shower. One, I like gold. Two, I like showers. Put it together. Hey, that sounds like the life.
If you're good, Santa Claus might give you a golden shower for Christmas.
Christmas? My man Santa.
And controversial R&B superstar R. Kelly will be heading into court tomorrow for the first day of his latest highly anticipated trial for child pornography and lewd acts with a local minor.
Granddad, can you take us into the city tomorrow to watch the R. Kelly trial?
Hell no. But you can walk.
It's 40 miles.
All the money I spent on them damn Nikes? You better just do it.
Assistant District Attorney Thomas Dubois is leading the prosecution of Kelly and has a mountain of evidence against the famous R&B performer, including a videotape allegedly showing Kelly urinating on a 14-year-old girl, which is widely available for download at www.freetopee.com.
I'm gonna go, check my email. Yeah.
Get your little short ass back here.
Hey, boys. Hey there, Huey.
Riley.
I couldn't help but notice your sign, and I hope you boys aren't too upset about me having to prosecute Mr. Kelly.
Hey, man, you do what you gotta do.
Why R. Kelly, huh? What did R. Kelly do to you?
He's accused of relieving himself on an underage girl on tape, which is against the law.
Okay. But let's examine this whole peeing thing. So I can pee in the toilet, and it's okay. But if I pee on a person, it's like, not okay.
Well, yeah.
Well, what if I'm peeing and Huey's in the bathroom and I accidentally pee on Huey? Should I go to jail?
What the hell would I be doing in the bathroom while you're in the bathroom?
Hold up. Remember when we used to sleep in the same bed when we was littler? From time to time, I'd have a little accident.
You still do?
Shut up! So, Mr. Dubois, Mr. I wanna lock niggas up for peeing. What's the statute of limitations on bedwetting? Why not prosecute me and R. Kelly at the same time, huh?
Now, Riley, no one's going to prosecute you for bedwetting.
And you shouldn't. It's a natural bodily function. And now every nigga in the world gonna be scared to pee. I may never pee again.
Riley, it was a little girl.
Oh, I seen that girl. She ain't little. I'm little.
Yes.
Gary Coleman's little.
Yes.
Mini-me is little.
Very.
And to the best of my knowledge, we all managed to avoid getting peed on so far.
But what about the victim?
Oh, yes, the victim. At what point does personal responsibility become a factor in this equation?
I don't think that's...
I see piss coming, I move.
Mm.
She saw piss coming, she stayed.
Yes, she did,
And why should I have to miss out on the next R. Kelly album just for that?
You just got beat by an 8-year-old.
And if R. Kelly goes to jail, I'll piss on your cat.
I tell you, it sure is beautiful out here. White folks sure know how to make some nice foliage.
Oh, come on, Ruckus. You can't give the white man credit for the trees.
Where them two little nappy-headed grandkids are y'all?
They went into the city to watch the trial of that singer.
Oh, right. That black sumbitch that's supposed to have had urinary relations with that underage color gal.
Didn't Jerry Lee Lewis marry a 14-year-old baby?
You can't compare a chocolate monkey like R. Kelly to Jerry Lee Lewis. Jerry Lee Lewis is the king of rock and roll. Great balls of fire. Besides, that situation was different. That was family.
We're here at the R. Kelly trial, where there are a handful of angry protesters making their voices heard. These are scholars, activists, pillars of the African-American community, and they are outraged. And we're just going to head over here to the R. Kelly supporters, where it's quite the festive event. And you are...
Hi!
Now, why did you come out here to support R. Kelly?
I say good!
And what about those protesters over there who say he's crossed the line?
Man, fuck them literate-ass uppity niggas. All they talk about is reading and eating right. Nobody want to hear all that shit. If I want to get high blood pressure, then nigga, get the cure away from me. If I want to get high blood pressure, then damn it, that's my business.
Let's talk to another R. Kelly supporter. You there, urban youth. Why do you think R. Kelly is innocent?
If I started peeing on you right now, would you A, smile and ask for more, or B, move the hell out the way? But before you answer that, let me ask America, has pee ever really hurt anybody? And I want to give a big shout out to my homie, Diva! What's up?
Okay, that's enough. Oof.
Get off me! Get off me, Huey! Free R. Kelly!
Hey, yo! Look, the R. Kelly haters are pressing that little boy.
Free R. Kelly! Free R. Kelly!
I knew it would be just a matter of time before violence broke out. It's pandemonium here in the R. Kelly trial. Oh, the humanity!
Mr. Kelly, do you have a statement?
This is truly an example of black people sticking together. In the words of Sister Soldier, an injustice anywhere is an injustice anywhere. Amen.
What did O.J. Simpson say to Kobe after his case was over?
What's that?
Don't let this whole trial thing turn you off to white women.
That's funny on so many levels. Lord, I just wish they would let me on that jury, boy. Thank God for the white man's code of law. It's the only way to keep these crazy niggas under control. Well, that and pepper spray. You know, I sat on the jury one time.
Really?
Oh, yeah. It was in 1957, back in Tennessee. Now, the defendant was accused of shooting three little white women with a Winchester rifle from about 50 yards away. See, now, he thought he was gonna get off of that old I'm blind excuse. But, oh, boy, he had another thing coming.
The jury will now go off and deliberate on...
Guilty! That nigga is guilty!
Sir, settle down. You have to go deliberate.
I don't need to deliberate. Hang that nigga now. I got the rope right here. Kang mean.
Lady Liberty is on our side. Justice will prevail. The judge and jury will do the right thing.
I'm telling you, Huey, it's an open and shut case.
Mr. Dubois, are you fully aware of the extent to which niggas love R. Kelly?
Oh, Huey, it's under control. Watch me work. And so, ladies and gentlemen, not only will we prove it is Mr. Kelly in the video, we will prove that the victim was 14 at the time the video was shot.
Thank you, Mr. Dubois, and now we'll have the opening statement for the defense.
The ancient Greeks, the architects of Western civilization, would regularly indulge in sexual activities with children. Were they perverts? In Puritan America, the forefathers of this great land would take wives who were 12 or 13 years old, much younger than the alleged victim. Were they sickos? In Tokyo, you could buy teenage girls' panties in vending machines. Do we call them disgusting? Of course not. What do all those things have to do with Robert Kelly? Nothing. Let's get to the point. Now, some people see this so-called mountain of evidence, these videotapes, photographs, eyewitnesses, and DNA, and see a guilty man. But some of us can see that mountain of so-called evidence for what it really is. Racism.
Yeah. Oh, he said it right there.
Which one was the one that got caught with that homely little white gal?
Kobe.
Right. Now, I know exactly what happened to Kobe. Kobe caught that white fever. White fever get in your blood, man, it'll make you crazy. And you know they got them short little skates nowadays and that, what they call them, the tongs?
Thongs.
Yeah, right. They got the thongs all up the booty crack, and they got that sweet white nectar. Oh, Lord, have mercy. And after that, it's over. You wake up and you don't even know what you done done. Just a pool of sweat around your ankles and a deep sense of satisfaction. Give me a minute, Robert.
You look like you need to take five.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I present to you the R. Kelly tape. I warn you, it is graphic.
Yeah!
Oh, no, he's dead.
Objection, we can't even see his face clearly.
Oh man, he got freckles and everything.
That proves nothing.
Hello, yes, this is Robert Kelly. Yes, the singer. You are my social security number. Sure, it's 916-34-7865. Okay, God bless.
Well,
Now, young lady, I know this might be hard to talk about.
No, it's cool.
How old were you when you were seeing Mr. Kelly?
14 and a quarter.
Wow. That's a great age, isn't it? Still learning so much about the world.
Whatever, I guess.
Could you describe the events leading up to the shooting of the video?
Yeah, he asked if he could pee on me, and I said, for sure. I mean, it's R. Kelly, the Pied Piper of R&B. I've been peed on by guys that don't even have record deals. Shit, if I didn't want to get peed on, I'd just move out the way. Ha, I told you.
Order. Would you describe yourself as an African-American woman?
Nigga, you blind?
No, I'm not. So it's safe to say that R. Kelly is sexually attracted to black women, right?
Mm-hmm.
Objection, relevance.
Your Honor, I'm trying to establish to the court that my client is a proud black man who loves his black sisters, unlike District Attorney Dubois, who's married to a white woman.
Now, I've listened to your black ass talk all day about how much you can't stand black folks.
Ain't two of them in the history of the world that's worth a squirrel for.
Oh, how much you love white folks?
Best thing the good Lord ever did for the planet Earth.
Ruckus, you black as Ace of Spades, man.
I don't see the need for you to go and insult the man after a game of checkers. We've been reminiscing all day, looking in each other's eyes, acting like we like each other. Now you gotta go ahead and remind me of my ailment.
Ailment?
That's right. You heard of vitiligo? Shoot, well, I got re-vitiligo. Every year, my skin just seemed to get blacker and darker and blacker and then more darker. It's the opposite of what Michael Jackson got. Lucky bastard.
Ruckus, how could you possibly love white people so much?
It's easy. Have you ever looked at them? White man just a joy to be around. They smell like lemon juice and Pledge furniture cleaner. And look at them. They gave us discipline, jobs, put structure in our lives, took us out the jungle. And what we do to show our appreciation? We march up and down the street. We vote. Carry on in grace.
Well, how about this? Game.
Nigga.
I'm going to show you something they don't want you to see. Something that will blow this case wide open. This is R. Kelly's NAACP Image Award Certificate of Nomination.
Oh!
Amy, you got his card? He's good. Did you wash your hands?
You think they nominate just anyone for this award?
I got one.
You know why he wants to put R. Kelly in jail? Why? Because he's afraid of R. Kelly. Oh.
Objection! Would you be quiet?
I think he's afraid. I think the whole system is afraid of R. Kelly.
Your Honor, please!
If you don't shut up!
They're afraid because they see the power for good that this man wields through his music. Yes, they do. They don't want R. Kelly to be free because they don't want you to be free. They don't want me to be free. Maybe R. Kelly did urinate on this woman, but America urinated on R. Kelly.
Oh.
And if you let them put this man in jail, America will urinate on each and every one of you. Salaamu Alaikum.
Alaikum Salaam, brother.
Please, people, you saw the tape. The girl testified she was underage. You're not allowed to do that to a little girl. We have a videotape.
Go tell that to your white bitch. Mm-hmm.
But the girl was... Prosecution rests.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, all that needs to be said is this.
Mandela? Yes, the government conspires to put a lot of innocent black men in jail on fallacious charges. But R. Kelly is not one of those men. We all know the nigga can sing. But what happened to standards? What happened to bare minimums? You a fan of R. Kelly? You want to help R. Kelly? Then get some counseling for R. Kelly. Introduce him to some older women. Hide his camcorder. But don't pretend like the man is a hero. And stop the damn dancing! Act like you got some goddamn sense, people! Damn! Don't play around here! Boo! Hey, you with the afro! Give it a rest! Beat it! Put the music back on! You're stressing me. I did battle with ignorance today, and ignorance won. I admit that I'm often vexed at the behavior of my own people. Yeah, vexed is a good word.
I told you about messing with them white women.
You do what you can to help black folks, and they make you wonder why you even bother. But they're our people, and we gotta love them regardless. One thing for sure, though, can't blame this one on the white man. What am I saying? Of course I can.